Erected in 1958 for the World Expo in Brussels, the Atomium, which represents an iron molecule magnified billions of times, was supposed to have been removed again 6 months later. However, the people of Brussels could not bring themselves to remove their world-famous landmark, and so in 2005, the Atomium was due for a full refurbishment. The quirky formation reaches 102 meters into the sky. For a while in 2005, a Liebherr LR1351LN crawler crane from Belgian crane specialist Sarens towered around 40 meters over it. A lattice boom crane had to complete the work on the topmost of the nine spheres due to its height and the fact that a radius of up to 76 meters was required.
Welcome
to the third edition of UpLoad this year. Large cranes erecting world-famous structures like the one in Brussels are impressive, of course. However, small compact cranes are in high demand every day all over the world. They help to relocate equipment, often in industrial buildings and in old towns. Dr. Hamme, our compact crane is now also available with a second alternative boom system.
Yes, that's exactly right. We've made our very successful LTC a 50-ton crane, available with a second boom system. To date, the crane has been very successful with a high-speed telescoping system, which Liebherr calls telematic. We've managed to sell over 500 of them with this system. We've now decided to offer a second boom with a different extension system, a rope pull mechanism.
Why are we now giving our customers a choice between two different systems?
The LTC 1050-3.1 is a very special crane. It is a very compact single cab crane. It is the only crane available from Liebherr with a C for compact in its name. However, it is also an all-terrain crane. It has to work in very constricted areas and is ideal for working under roofs, for example. On the other hand, crane contractors do not receive this type of job every day, so it has to be suitable for ordinary use, just like an LTM. In other words, we need it to be a jack of all trades. And discussions with our customers showed that we had not quite managed it, that in fact this second boom with the rope pull mechanism was missing from the package, which is why we've now added it.
Various criteria have to be taken into consideration when choosing the boom and telescoping system. On the one hand, we have the hard arguments based on technical facts, which can also be expressed in figures. But then, there are also the soft factors.
Yes, of course, and this is exactly what we have to understand. The soft factors are mentioned. The hard factors are relatively clear. They include lifting capacity, which is always a major topic, lifting capacity on a long boom, and lifting capacity on a short boom, lifting capacity on a raised boom, and lifting capacity on a long radius. Then there is the boom length, another hard fact. But it is also interesting, how short is the shortest retracted boom? If I'm working under a roof, the roof above me is a problem, which means it's great if the basic boom is very short. If I now telescope it with the load, that whole process has to be done very sensitively. Sensitively means I must be able to position a load precisely superimposed with other movements by the crane. That is a very sensitive task, which the crane operator has to manage using his master switch. And to do so, he needs a great deal of skill. Many small all-terrain cranes, including LTM cranes, have a rope pull system. The crane operators are really well trained and can handle it, and they are delighted when they get a very last drop out of the LTC.
That means that in the future, the customer can choose between the powerful long telematic or fast familiar rope pull technology.
That's exactly the point. Everything is the same in the basic machine, including the ballast. That means the customer can decide on a high-speed boom or a rope pull boom. The whole thing is configurable. He can make his choice when he orders the crane. And if he can't decide, no problem. He can order two cranes from us. We won't mind.
Great. Thank you very much for your input, Dr. Hamme.
Don't mention it.
From very compact to the ultimate on eight axles. We have a new LTM 1650-8.1 leaving the factory in Ehingen every week at the moment. And these new, immensely powerful 8-axle cranes are being used for some very interesting, sometimes even explosive jobs. Let's go to Lünen for the demolition of a power plant. Crane contractor Wasel is providing support here for the demolition of the coal-fired power plant. It's set up a crane for this job with a complete range of equipment, 91-meter luffing jib and 145 tons of ballast. The crane was used to hoist the explosives experts, so they could place their explosives on the chimney. As usual, when transporting personnel on a crane, special equipment is required, such as the emergency hydraulic unit for an emergency takedown in the event of a crane failure. The explosives were put in position at a height of 145 meters, while the chimney itself was 250 meters high. The final explosion was a complete success. Large to small, old to new, on wheels or crawlers, the daily bread of our colleagues in the repair department is the refurbishment of used cranes. Every crane is different and has its own story. And the refurbishment is also an individual affair. The buyer decides which work is carried out. Depending on what the customer wants, our professionals can carry out repair, installation, polishing and modernization work on the crane. Stefan, what's the actual procedure for the general refurbishment of an accident-damaged crane?
The first thing is to inspect the complete crane for damage. This includes dismantling the crane and taking its components apart. We remove certain components and return them to the suppliers. This enables the component experts to dismantle and inspect them properly. Depending on what they find, a decision is made as to whether the components are repaired or replaced. During this, our colleagues check every individual part on the crane and start the refurbishment work. Every single part of the crane is checked. At the same time, we carry out servicing work, such as replacing oil and filters, and conduct a number of function tests. Finally, we hand over a fully functional, powerful crane with a familiar high Liebherr quality to the customer.
Why does Liebherr refurbish cranes that have been written off? And what's especially important in this process?
A Liebherr crane is still a Liebherr crane, even if it has been badly damaged. It is a quality product. When we, the manufacturer, refurbish a Liebherr crane, we can be certain that the crane will continue to meet our familiar high-quality standards and our internal factory standards. We attach great value to safety when we refurbish accident-damaged cranes. At the same time, we ensure that we reuse as many parts as possible. For example, we take the intact electrical and pneumatic systems, or even individual components out of a damaged cab and reuse them in a new cab. That saves resources.
Yet another contribution towards sustainability. And it's very impressive to see how an accident-damaged crane can be returned to peak condition. Thank you very much for your insights today, Stefan.
Pleasure.
The coronavirus pandemic has now had a firm grip on our everyday lives for around a year and a half. Nevertheless, during 2020, around 2,000 mobile and crawler cranes still left our crane production plant here in Ehingen and were delivered to customers all over the world. Sometimes this process has involved obstacles or circuitous routes. Stefan, how were you able to maintain the flow of goods all this time?
We quickly noticed that there were major regional differences in how the pandemic was being tackled. On the one hand, borders were being closed, whilst on the other, there were complete lockdowns of individual sectors of industry in some regions. In other words, our challenge was to ship as many products as possible here to Ehingen so that we could continue to maintain our production and service.
Giulio, what can you tell us about our receiving department during this time?
At the outset, the whole thing was chaotic, of course, due to the pandemic. So that meant it was important for us to act quickly and implement a hygiene concept, providing masks, gloves and disinfectant, some of which we had to purchase through platforms like eBay. Quite simply, safety had to take priority. In addition, deliveries became more volatile than previously. Time lost on the road was made up by truck drivers, leading to them arriving in numbers, and of course, we had to clear all of them.
Normally, our deliveries are very, very strictly timed. But at times like this, that simply does not work. When borders are closed and truck drivers have to be tested for coronavirus, it all automatically means delays. To relieve the situation a little, we set up buffers, some of which were for several days. But of course, that also led to trucks arriving in numbers, as Giulio has already mentioned, and all of them had to be dealt with separately.
Closed borders, but nevertheless spare parts supplies and reliable crane repairs by our experts here in Ehingen. Stefan, how has all this been possible?
Literally, in this case, by being close to our customers. In fact, many, many years ago, we took the basic decisions we at Liebherr Ehingen needed a global, close-knit network of our own service outlets in every major region of the world. And this meant that local spare parts, warehousing of critical parts, and competence at these outlets enabled us to handle well over 90% of service calls locally. And during the pandemic, we even increased this to well over 95%. That was the key. Ultimately, it is a mixture of continuous investment in the qualifications and competence of our service network. The other thing is that remote service is far from a new concept to us, because at the end of the day, telephone service has been standard for decades. For the last few years, we have created additional facilities in the form of remote diagnostic software. With the agreement of our customers, this enables us to read data and identify the fault more quickly. But if even that is not enough, once again, the fact our service network is close to our customers made the difference, above all when travel restrictions were imposed during the pandemic, as it meant we did not have to cross international borders to continue to provide our customers with the service they needed. Right at the end, when things really turned bad and we had to send our crane experts from Ehingen out on flights, we even invested in our own coronavirus PCR testing system to ensure we could obtain a test certificate from them within minutes.
We now have some challenging months behind us. What do you think we've learned from the pandemic?
For one thing, that our supply chain is rock solid and it works. For another, however, the last few months have shown us what we've been missing, namely talking to people and receiving visits. In other words, we're already looking forward to visits and talking to suppliers about our continuing working relationship, ways to improve, but also about growth, of course.
If we can take anything at all positive from the pandemic, it's that it has certainly been a catalyst for remote service, both for us and for our customers. If there is one thing we feel fully vindicated about, however, it is our reliable, rock-steady partnerships, which enable us to find solutions together.
What we have learned, what has been confirmed, is that the key to success is through our colleagues. That means it's important that as management staff we maintain a cool head at all times. We have people from 20 different countries working in the logistics department. A pandemic is not enough to stop them wanting to visit their friends and relations during their holidays, which in turn leads to quarantine requirements.
Thanks to all three of you for these insights into your not everyday daily work during these challenging times. And finally, for this edition, we're in fact crossing a border into Switzerland. Here's one of the first LTM 1120-4.1 cranes in action. True to its slogan, there's nothing more on four. Crane contractor Christian & Beale's new LTM 1120-4.1 is in action erecting the structural steelwork for the construction of a new industrial building in Switzerland. Because the crane had to be positioned on an arterial route, Vario Base proved absolutely essential at the site. And again, for dismantling a tower crane a few kilometers away, the new four-axle crane again impressed its operator.
I am delighted with the new crane. We can move to a different site in a very short order and set it up again very quickly as the erection times are very short.
And that brings us to the end of this edition for today. And I'm looking forward to seeing a few innovations and a trip to Las Vegas in the next edition. See you then.